In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Excuse me. Today, as I said yesterday, we wear the vestment with a little bit of blue for the water of baptism, the waters of the Jordan, as the Lord went to the Jordan to be baptized by John. His baptism is a baptism of repentance, so we'll begin with the Confiteor. Let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words and what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who, when Christ had been baptized in the river Jordan, and as the Holy Spirit descended upon him, solemnly declared him your beloved Son, grant that your children by adoption, reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, may always be well-pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. O come to the water, all you who are thirsty, though you have no money, come, buy corn without money and eat, and at no cost, wine and milk. Why spend money in what is not bread, your wages in what fails to satisfy? Listen to me, and you will have good things to eat and rich food to enjoy. Pay attention, come to me, listen, and your soul will live. With you I will make an everlasting covenant out of the favours promised to David. See, I have made of you a witness to the peoples, a leader and a master of the nations. See, you will summon a nation you never knew. Those unknown will come hurrying to you for the sake of the Lord your God, of the Holy One of Israel, who will glorify you. Seek the Lord while he is still to be found. Call to him while he is still near. Let the wicked man abandon his way, the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn back to the Lord, who will take pity on him, to be our God, who is rich in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, my ways not your ways. It is the Lord who speaks. Yes, the heavens are as high above the earth as my ways are above your ways, my thoughts above your thoughts. Yes, as the rain and the snow come down from the heavens and do not return without watering the earth, and making it yield and giving growth to provide seed for the sower and bread for the eating, so the word that goes from my mouth does not return to me empty, without carrying out my will and succeeding in what it was sent to do. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Response to the psalmist. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Truly God is my salvation. I trust I shall not fear. For the Lord is my strength, my song. He became my saviour. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Give thanks to the Lord. Give praise to his name. Make his mighty deeds known to the peoples. Declare the greatness of his name. Joy, you will draw water from the wells of salvation. Sing a psalm to the Lord, for he has done glorious deeds. Make them known to all the earth. People of Zion, sing and shout for joy, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel. With joy, you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. In the course of his preaching, John the Baptist said, "Someone is following me, someone who is more powerful than I am, and I am not fit to kneel down and undo the strap of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." It was at this time that Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized in the Jordan by John. No sooner had he come up out of the water than he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit like a dove descending on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. My favor rests on you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Have this impressive moment when we call it the beginning of the Lord's public ministry. For roughly 30 years, he had quite a quiet life, and then with John, John's baptizing in the Jordan, this is the moment the Lord himself decides, this is when I have to step forward, urged by the Holy Spirit. And so, obviously, the Holy Spirit was with the Lord all from in his humanity from the beginning, but of his humanity. But there's something special happening with the public ministry beginning. The Lord then goes forward with his words and his deeds, miracles, and to Calvary and his death and resurrection. But just now it's this moment of being guided by the Spirit to this humanity to go to the waters of the Jordan, receive this baptism of John, baptism of repentance. But the Lord brings what's called baptism in the Holy Spirit. And it's just like this I'd like to pick up on here today. In the preface we're going to hear shortly, it talks about the Spirit's descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. So because of the Holy Spirit coming upon the Lord, then Jesus is anointed with the oil of gladness. And I brought along here the holy oils, and one of them is the chrism oil. So it says C on it, C for chrism, for Christ as well. So this is the oil of gladness, because it represents the Holy Spirit coming on us. It brings the Holy Spirit to us. So just to be clear, there are all sorts of people here for the phrase oil of gladness elsewhere, but to avoid confusion, just call them blessed oils. The true oil of gladness in the Catholic faith is chrism oil, which I have in my hand. It's used at baptism, it's used at confirmation, and it's used at ordination to the priesthood and holy orders. Now, they're not, they can sit in, usually these ones sit in the safe in the sacristy, but behind the Christmas tree, there's a little cabinet there, and that's where they can be kept there as well. Sometimes you go into a church and there's a little cabinet, locked cabinet. We can't see very well from just today, but you might see better on the screen. That's where we keep the holy oils. B for those about to be baptized, C for baptism, confirmation, and holy orders. And I for infirmorum, oil of the sick, of the infirm. So it's just in case, just in passing, I'm saying that. So the chrism then is the oil of gladness. The chrism then is the oil which brings the Holy Spirit on us. So we don't. And so this is given to Jesus for his purpose, to bring good news to the poor, is what is said. Jesus, so the chrism, as it were, is giving a task. The Holy Spirit is tasking us with bring for Jesus, it was bring good news to the poor. For us, normally, then, we have obviously to try to do our best and bring good news to the poor. But I think it's quite significant that you're not baptized again. You're baptized only once. You're confirmed only once. If you're ordained a priest, you're only ordained a priest. Now, you might wander away from the faith and so on, but if you come back, you wouldn't be baptized again. You wouldn't be confirmed again. You wouldn't, as a priest, I wouldn't be ordained again, because it changes you. It changes what's called the character of who you are. And I'd like to hone in on that, because in this time, just now, because we're not able to get to the sacraments, which is repeatable, but the normal sacrament of Holy Communion for a Catholic, we're not able to receive Holy Communion in a normal way, then we should fall back on our chrism. The anointing by the Holy Spirit would be given by baptism, confirmation. So that's what we should fall back on and remind yourself that is not taken away, even though you're not able to get to Mass the way you'd like. Nonetheless, you've been set a direction by your baptism, by your confirmation, and by my priesthood, set a direction the same way Jesus and his humanity at the beginning of his public ministry. By his Spirit's descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. The oil of gladness you and I have received by our baptism, may most of us then also by our confirmation. Bidding prayers now, list out the creed. The response is to let us pray to the Lord is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. That church born of water and the Spirit may be filled with new power for good. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That people of every nation may be cleansed from hatred and violence. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit may be freed from every evil. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That we who form one people in Jesus Christ may be made more perfectly like him. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Now then, prayers are asked to ask for the sick. We know, and those we don't know, people carry illnesses, as we know, and struggle silently. We pray that the Lord will reach, his healing touch will reach them too, but especially at this time, Rosemary Harris and Marie Wall. For the happy repose of the souls of Alice Douglas, now Ballach Eastfield, I should have come to usually 11:40 Mass regularly, but the funeral then is going to be at a fortnight and Monday. So that's Monday, 25th of January, coming in just before Mass. So that's for Alice Douglas. Also, Nora Curry, Raymond Fazzini, John Lennon, and Billy Ryan. Special remembrance at this time for Therese Krasinkis McKenna, Paddy and Sarah Doolin, Sammy and Alice Waters, deceased members of the McCourt family, deceased members of the McGrath family, Mary McCann Waters, Peter Jr. Waters. Anniversary at this time for Peter McKendry, Larry Differ, Patrick O'Brien, James Hester, Pat Livingston, Robert Mellon, Danny Rooney, James Taggart, Eleanor Ballantyne, Isabella Aitken Brady, Margaret Nash Livingston, Kathleen McDade Livingston, George Brady, Agnes Barnes, Catherine Foley, Mustafa Elbana, Annie Jess, Tracy Wilson, John Gribben, William Morrison Sr., David Reed, Arthur McKell, Andrew Killiard, Alicia Killiard, Peter Cushley, and Ian Shanks. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May their souls and souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. We had our own intentions in our heart. O God, whose only begotten Son has appeared in our very flesh, grant, we pray, that we may be inwardly transformed through him whom we recognise as outwardly like ourselves, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Okay, as we know, I'm going to move to the altar now for the preparation of the gifts. Sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accepts the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought to honour the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of him who willed in his compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Lord, be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, from the waters of the Jordan you revealed with signs and wonders a new baptism, so that through the voice that came down from heaven we might come to believe in your word dwelling among us, and by the Spirit's descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ your servant has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave a chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Third one, the mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Philip, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we use the prayer that was given to us at our baptism. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Offer each other in our family bubbles a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those joining us through the internet, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly entreat your mercy, O Lord, that faithfully listening to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a couple of things. Just we're into lockdown again, as you know, those that join us anyway. Many of us never left, you know, because of particular situations, and we're all different. Be patient. I think we're more patient with others than with ourselves at times, so please be patient with yourself. Now, just particularly thank those who have stepped up to the mark these past months since we opened again, July to January. Those of normal volunteers who have been regular assists have still been there and all not far away. And then some have kept a low profile but really stepped up as we need the help, thinking particularly the sanitizers and the track and tracers, and then Holy Cross Stream Team, who have really made the life of the parish kept visible. Obviously, parishes keep going in a hidden way, but we've kept a visibility, which is wonderful. And just like mention Holy Cross Stream Team and the weeks ahead and the months ahead. We're not quite sure when all this will become back to normal. What's been really nice is the people meeting folk they've never spoke to before, because obviously you get into routines, certain masses and so on. It's a real blessing to the parish that folk admiring one another's fine work and solid presence. Obviously not everybody's been able to for different reasons. Not everyone's been able to, so please just appreciate the ones that are for able to come. Just this is the thing that if you have a look in the bulletin about Bethlehem and the Christians there and difficult situation, Palestinian Christians are particularly being squeezed there. Also, this is the Baptism of the Lord, so the Christmas season, as it were, ends. So tomorrow, we're in ordinary time. It's green, the normal colour. But so just, this is year of St. Joseph. We've got, so think of baptisms. I'll suggest that if anyone adds anybody with a baby born and wants to be baptised, if you, I'm thinking then if if you add Joseph or Josephine to the name, then I'll think of a special joke to reward you for this. And maybe I should promise not to tell a joke if you name the person Joseph or Josephine, if whatever you prefer. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May God bless you and your families this day, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.